Welcome back to The Pulse. I'm Francine Lacroix. Israeli investors are betting on more rate cuts after the central bank reversed monetary policy on Monday. The Bank of Israel Governor Stanley Fischer lowered the benchmark rate by a quarter point to 3%. That's the first reduction in 2.5 years. Well, Israel joins countries like Brazil and Turkey in taking steps to guard against a global economic slowdown. Fischer is also tracking problems closer to home, namely protests by Israelis over the high cost of living and managing a politically isolated economy.
The political isolation isn't necessarily, it's not good, but it isn't necessarily very serious from the economic viewpoint. The question is whether there will be other implications, for instance, violence or following a Palestinian declaration of a state, that happen. Those could be very serious, and of course the loss of the Turkish market, if that's what's happening, is a serious issue. Turkey is only 3% of our trade, but it's a rapidly growing economy, and it would be good to have that as a trading partner. Well, it's a real thing. I mean, you don't get 300,000 people demonstrating, furthermore, peacefully twice, unless there's something there. And there is something important there. It relates in part to the price of housing. It possibly relates to other phenomena, certainly to food prices, but also possibly to a general feeling that they're disappointed with other aspects, non-economic, of government policy. They didn't discuss that, but one has a feeling that this is a more broad protest.
That was Bank of Israel Governor Stanley Fischer speaking to Bloomberg earlier this month in Jerusalem.